We'll go ahead and get started now. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Eric Dryman. I'm the Division Chief of Training here at the Indianapolis Fire Department. This time I'd like to ask that the bagpiper in Class 84 go ahead and make their way into the auditorium. At this time, the Chief's Honor Guard will come to the stage and present the colors. This time we'll recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I'd like to welcome Chaplain Mike Gatliff to the podium for the invocation.
I invite you to join me for a moment of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we welcome your presence here for this exciting evening and a momentous day in the life of these recruits. I thank you for the opportunity that we have to gather together and celebrate with them and to continue to support them. I pray for all of our speakers this evening and the presentation that's going to be forthcoming. We do all this for your glory. Thank you for the blessings that you have given to the city of Indianapolis. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Please be seated. This time I'd like to welcome the Honorable Mayor Joe Hogsett to the podium to say a few words.
Well, indeed, good evening. It's a beautiful night to celebrate, is it not? And celebrate we shall. To our recruit class 84, it is the culmination of your training and the beginning, starting tomorrow or Wednesday or Thursday, of the best job in the world. The city of Indianapolis is proud to welcome the men and the women of the 84th recruit class of the Indianapolis Fire Department. As mayor, I would like to speak, if I may, on behalf of our entire community in saying how grateful we are, how grateful I am for the dedication you have shown at the academy and the service that you pledge to our city today, this evening. Your choice to serve and protect this city is itself an act of heroism, and I thank each of you for making that choice. The road ahead will be as challenging as it is rewarding. You will come to know this city. You will come to know its people, as few do. You will discover that every neighborhood in our city is connected by this one constant. Men, women, children everywhere who want to live safe, prosperous, and full lives. That's the common denominator in every neighborhood, in every corner, in every zip code. And for 160 years now, our city's fire department has dedicated itself to making sure that if an emergency should arise, residents of our city, the city we call home, Indianapolis, can expect the prompt arrival and the total commitment of our firefighters. But we also know your role extends beyond emergency scenarios. Just this past week, I gathered with Chief Malone and other IFD personnel to welcome their gift of the new fire training tower out at Arsenal Tech High School for that school's fire rescue program. In July, we got together to teach our community about fire safety and the IFD Fire Safety Festival at the Marion County Health Department. And there are so many events just like the two I've mentioned. And the reason is simple. A community's fire service is one of its most essential resources. Our community depends on the training, the ability, and the character of its firefighters. And so I say, your commitment to serving these residents is indeed nothing short of heroic. For despite the highs and the lows that come, and come they will, never doubt the critical role you play in our community. Without you, Indianapolis cannot be the safe place to live, to work, to raise a family, and yes, even to play, as we all wish it to be. So to our soon-to-be graduates, to all of your loved ones, your families, who have joined with you in this great Performing Arts Center tonight for this ceremony, and to our Indianapolis Fire Department, its command staff, and each and every one of its members. On behalf of a grateful city, on behalf of a grateful mayor, I say thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Hogsett. This time I'd like to introduce Chief Ernest Malone. Make a few words.
Well, thank you, Chief, and good evening, and thank you all for being here. Before we begin, there's a few people that I want to recognize. I hesitate to do that at most times I speak because you always miss someone, but I want to recognize the president of our IFD Merit Board, Tom Miller. Thank you for being here, sir. Please give him a hand. He does a great job for us. We have our partners in labor, Local 416 IFD District President Mike Scott is here. Mike, thank you for being here. And then last but certainly not least, I want to recognize our partners at IMPD. Assistant Chief of Department Randall Taylor is here to support us. So. Whenever I stand before you, there's always one more group that I recognize, and I'll ask you and join me in doing that, and that's thanking the 290 firefighters that are on duty right now protecting us so we can enjoy this ceremony. Peace. Well, tonight is a big night for our recruits, soon to be probationary firefighters. I would like to congratulate you on completing a very difficult training program. I also wanted to tell them thank you. Thank you for your willingness to step up and do something that I think is very special. I believe all things considered, the mental and physical aspects involved in this program make it the most challenging one there is to offer anywhere. To the family and friends tonight, I offer our thanks for your patience during the class. I know the hours were long, and we sent them home tired and grumpy on more than one occasion. As you see them here tonight, please be proud of them. They have been through a lot, and they have earned it. Class 84, if you remember on the first day of recruit school, I congratulated you on completing a very difficult selection process. I told you that 68 IFD recruits had been chosen out of nearly 2,100 applicants who applied to be Indianapolis firefighters and who wanted to be sitting in the chairs you were sitting in that morning. I also told them that number 69 did not make it. Now, I don't know who number 69 was. He or she may have become a terrific firefighter, a respected member of our community and of this firefighting family. But I ask that as you go through your training, I wanted you to think about number 69. When you didn't want to study, when they got stressed, when you were tired from all the physical fitness training and evolutions on the drill pad, and you just didn't think you could make it, I ask that when things got tough, and that you maybe even thought about quitting, that you remembered number 69. You owed it to him or her to pull yourself together and finish what you started. And all of you here this evening did just that. We made something else very clear to you from the onset. We did not just take their application. We would require their commitment. A commitment to our city. We are one city. A commitment to our department. We are one fire department. And an unabashed and unyielding commitment to each other. It's my understanding that your class motto is no strength without unity. I think that's very fitting because at IFD, that's how we do it. Tonight, you will not only stand proudly with the other 1,300 men and women of the IFD, but all of you will join the over 1 million firefighters that make up the United States Fire Service, and I think that's a pretty special group to belong to. I did not get out to see you train as much as I would have liked, but I did get to observe you on a few occasions. One of the first times was on the training pad. I saw would-be firefighters at different comfort levels acting as individuals, some struggling to get acclimated to the new and somewhat strange equipment that we use in firefighting. I recall seeing some of the instructors give new meaning to the term hands-on training, as they were ever so softly and gently offering encouragement to the recruits that seemed to be having trouble following instructions. A short time ago, I had another opportunity to visit them on the training site. This time I saw more confident recruits, not having equipment or retention or other issues, but performing the required task at a high level of confidence and proficiency. You see, what started out as a group of individuals was now a team of 68 professionals. After 30 weeks of intensive training in fire operations, emergency medical, hazardous materials, incident management, SCBA Hell Week, and many other specialties, perhaps the only thing more exciting the men accepted into the recruit class last February is tonight. It's graduation night. It's your night. I want to let everyone know that the excitement level of these recruits to get on the street and put what they have learned into practice is probably rivaled only by the sheer giddiness of the current subpool to have these folks behind them on the seniority list. Thank you to the station crews and other firefighters who assisted with the class. Rest assured, our crews are also excited and they eagerly await your arrival so they can teach you what you really need to know. Later this evening, you will all raise your right hand and you'll take an oath. I'm asking that each of you tonight not just take the oath, but that you let the oath take you. Being a firefighter is not a job, it's a way of life. You are always on duty, you will always be held to a higher standard, and you will always be accountable to your brother and sister firefighters. You will face many challenges as you begin your service to this community. Whether at a fire station or on the street, remember these two things, please. We don't treat people as bad as they are. We treat them as good as we are. There are choices you will have to make in nearly everything you do out there. So keep in mind that in the end, the choices you make will make you. The recruits were told early in their training that at the beginning, they did a great job of saying the right things, but now it was time to do the right things. As you grew, you experienced teamwork. You learned unity. You have established bonds that will last throughout your careers. Even after 20, 30, or 40 years on this department, when you see each other or talk about each other, You will say, "That's my classmate, and we came on together back in 2019. That just sounds ridiculous to me that people would just be starting this wonderful career in 2019. Okay, I'll keep going. To Chief White, Chief Kresbach, Chief Dryman, and the entire training staff and support crew, I commend you for doing an outstanding job in preparing these men and women for the challenges they will face. Those challenges begin tomorrow morning. Your service is required, and your city awaits. I want to remind everyone here that each day as you drive through our city, you may pass fire stations and fire equipment. I want you to know that each time you see a man or woman wearing our uniform, you are seeing a public servant who is highly trained and deeply committed to keeping you and your family safe. We truly embrace the sentiment that in our organization, it's our family serving your family. I thank you. I'm proud to serve with you. And my last closing remark will be, recruits, I'd like to offer you this challenge. Remember the lessons you have learned. Stay safe and continue to learn as you progress through your career. Your education is not over. It's just beginning. I want you to be lifetime learners. I challenge you to also maintain your physical fitness and by all means your personal integrity. The reputation of the Indianapolis Fire Department is of the highest standard. It was earned by the blood, sweat, heroism, and even the lives of those who came before us. From this day forward, you represent the city of Indianapolis, the IFD, your class, and all of the firefighters who serve with you. You are the future of our service. You have a legacy to uphold. And I challenge you to advance that legacy. As the mayor said, the Indianapolis Fire Department is a 160-year-old organization that has a very proud history and tradition. I wanted to assure the mayor, the city council, other city leaders, members of our department, and every single citizen of Marion County that I believe Recruit Class 84 has the heart to keep that tradition and the ability to safeguard our community. Thank you. Congratulations and well done.
Thank you, Chief Malone. Now it's my turn. 30 weeks is a long time, and I'm not sure who's happier about tonight, those of you in the audience or those of us up here on the stage. All right, we're glad we're all here to celebrate. I want to start by thanking this great group of fire EMS and fitness instructors that are sitting up here on the stage, as well as the other administrative chiefs and STOs, FTOs, and companies who came out over the course of these 30 weeks to provide the training that your loved ones received. Your instructors have made sure that you have the necessary knowledge and skills required to be a firefighter. Without their efforts, we would not be here this evening. So let's give them a round of applause, please. Class 84, this is the day you've been waiting for. Today is the last day that I will be referring to you as recruits. This is an exciting time for all of you. Over the course of this week, you will all report to a firehouse for the first time, where your education and learning will be put to the test. You will truly get to report and say that you are an Indianapolis firefighter. I want to remind you of a few things before your first day at the firehouse. To be called a firefighter and a member of the Indianapolis Fire Department carries a tremendous amount of responsibility. This job will place demands on you far beyond what the general public will ever realize. Being a firefighter requires trust, honor, and loyalty. In a few minutes, Chief Malone will administer the oath of office and you will be sworn in officially as Indianapolis firefighters. As of today, you are being given the privilege to serve the citizens of Indianapolis. You have asked for this privilege and today it will be granted. You have asked for the privilege to stand on the front line and assure the citizens that when they are having their worst day, when they have no place to turn, you will be there to fix their problem, ease their pain, or lead them on a path to safety. The privilege to say I am an Indianapolis firefighter comes with the responsibility of trust. When you leave here tonight, you will automatically have the public's trust. This trust comes not because of who you are or what you've learned over the last 30 weeks. It has been paved by the men and women who came before you. A trust that makes the citizens comfortable when you enter their homes during their most vulnerable times. A trust so deep that a mother will give you her own child freely, knowing that you can be trusted with that child's life. A trust that says, no matter how dire a situation is, I will not leave my partner's side, nor will my partner leave mine. If you violate that trust, you are no longer worthy of being one of us. The privilege you are asking for comes with the responsibility of honor. You must honor the traditions and history of this fire department. These traditions have been paid for by the men and women who paved the way for you to be here today. Lastly, the privilege that you ask for comes from the responsibility of loyalty. Loyalty to one another and to the company you are serving in. The test of your loyalty will not come in the good times. It will come when things truly turn bad. It means supporting one another, no matter how bad things get, and saying we will get through this together. We will not let this beat us. Class 84, congratulations on your completing of recruit class. Good luck on the streets, never stop learning, and always take care of one another. At this time, I would like to ask Daniel McManus and Shantae Holland, class leaders, to come up, say a few words.
Sounds like mine. Good evening, and thank you for coming. Tonight marks the end of a process and the start of another. Nearly a year and a half ago, this class started a hiring process through which we somehow, out of over 2,100 applicants, were selected for recruit class 84. That started February 25th. I would like to thank Mayor Hogsett, Chief Malone, all the chief officers, the administration personnel, for opportunity to serve the community, fulfill dreams, make our families proud, and provide a better life for our children. Thank you to the EMS staff for giving us the guidance needed to be good EMTs and maybe tell a few stories of our own. Thank you to the PT staff for sacrificing your early mornings and giving us the tools necessary to be able to have a 20 or 30 year career and retire as healthy as possible. To the fire staff, you took on the challenge of teaching us not only traditions of the Indianapolis Fire Department, but what it takes to do this job with honor and respect. All the years of experience and knowledge that you bestowed upon us to get the job done and get home safely is invaluable. Thank you. Let me not forget the instructors that devoted time to give us insight and training in special operations such as hazmat, water and dive rescue, vehicle extrication, and rope rescue. Thank you. And to the engine and ladder companies that came out and gave us daily hands-on knowledge and valuable street experience to help us better understand that our work is unpredictable and complacency is deadly, and always keep our head on a swivel. Thank you as well. Last but not least, I want to especially thank all the families and friends. You were as much affected by this process as we were. You made sacrifices so that we would be able to fulfill the needs of being a firefighter. the long hours being away from home and having us come home just to say, sorry, I have to study, I don't have time, I need to iron. Basically saying, I'm home, but I'm not available. You listened to us gripe about everything, and no matter how unpleasant or annoyed we were, you always took care of business at home. It is not only us who answered the call, it is also you. We would not be here tonight without you. To serve the community as a firefighter, we must disregard that instinct to run the other direction when there's trouble. A firefighter does not run away, but runs toward the trouble seeking to save lives and property. To be willing to sacrifice oneself in order to do whatever it takes to make sure someone else can see another day. This willingness to answer the call is what makes this job immense, an immense brother and sisterhood. Not only do we fight for the community, but we fight for each other as well. Not everyone can answer the call, which is why there's such a strenuous process to find those who will. This class was unique in that with this amount of recruits, the class had to be split, which is why there are two of us standing here today. I was assigned to lead the A side of the class, and Dan was assigned to lead B. For the first 4.5 months, the entire class was only together in the morning for PT. One side completed both fire school and EMS class, and then you would flip-flop. And then we came back together in July for drills on the pad. Captain Strain told us in the beginning that once we all got out on the pad, we would be doing skills until we were sick of them. Well, you were right, sir. He was so right that we all prayed for everything you can think of. Things like torrential downpours, your gear not being back from the quartermaster, anything for a break. The days were so hot that we even prayed for a few days in the classroom doing anything. Yes, that was an EMS refresher. I know Captain Quinn jumped at that opportunity to grace us with his presence for those 2 days. What? Sorry. To the class, 30 weeks. Wow, 30 weeks. I don't know about you guys, but I don't remember what I did before the academy. It feels like a generation ago. Dan and myself were chosen to lead this class, and we thank you especially for letting us guide this vessel to where we are now, graduation. As I was writing this speech, I struggled to find the right words, as I'm doing now, to best sum up this class. What it boils down to, there aren't any. I remember February 25th sitting down in the basement at headquarters looking around at everyone who pretty much had the same look on their face as I did, that look of, what did I get myself into? Prior to the start of the academy, we all pretty much had a place where we knew where we stood in life. And then this journey started, and so ended that certainty of our place. I'm pretty sure we all had the same mindset coming in. Be quiet, don't get noticed in the wrong way, don't stand out too much, learn as much as possible. That certainly was my goal. This class has been one in which we've experienced every emotion possible. Happy to pass the NREMT exam, sad at the loss of a classmate, fear of not being biomechanically sound, paranoia from learning that the trailer maze was open that day, anger from someone sarcastically encouraging you with a bullhorn during SCBA week while blaring Michael Jackson's Man in the Mirror in the background while you're blacked out and exhausted in a basement. Thank you, Captain Cressy. I think I could also add traumatized to that as well. I will never forget. Embarrassment at the thought of having completed a great search just to find out that a victim was missed. Confusion from trying to understand DCJ's questions. But most importantly, proud. Proud to be a firefighter and to be able to walk with our heads held high knowing that we made it. As we walk out these doors tonight and go our separate ways, let us remember we are now and will forever be Class 84. Thank you sincerely. And as always, other than that, that's all I got. I'm now bring up Dan McManus to say a few words as well.
Thank you, Shante. I wish that everybody could have seen Captain Kretzig's face about 37 minutes ago when I told him that I didn't prepare any speech. So as I fervently wrote some notes down, this is kind of what I came up with. A lot of people that stand up here in front of this microphone, they say the words thank you. They start from a platform of gratitude and wash the words over this whole audience. But those are just words. How do you quantify, how do you display, how do you measure gratitude? The things that I can think of is that you apply the knowledge that's been given you from this staff, VMS instructors, PT, and fire instructors. For those who don't know, the fire department is getting younger, and with every day, knowledge retires that will be hard to get back and hard to understand how things used to be done. So apply the knowledge that you've received. Ask questions. Know what you don't know. These are things that you can do to be able to display to the incumbent firefighters in this community what the words thank you mean. And also, for those who don't know, we lost a recruit early in this academy, David Short. Unfortunately, he was in a tragic car accident and he lost his life. And this was amidst an environment of confusion to begin with, where you have, at that point, 67 individuals who really didn't know one another. And we were able to come together and pull a silver lining out of that tragic accident. So think of him on your bad days. Think of him and all the hard work that he put into getting this job and being a recruit with us in the beginning. I know that's what I'm going to do. The other thing I want to think of and talk about is the common tips that we heard over and over from the many shade tree talks that we had. Introduce yourself. I think every person that came and talked to us, firefighter, retiree, instructor, introduce yourself when you get to the firehouse. It's going to be embarrassing. You're going to have anxiety. But I think that point was driven into our head, the importance of letting people know who you are and that you're ready to come to work that day. Have two ears and one mouth. That goes back to how do you measure gratitude? Understand that you are there to learn. You don't know everything. I don't know everything. And take it as an opportunity to learn every day when you're with the incumbent firefighters. Have a good attitude and effort. That's pretty much self-explanatory. And like Mayor Hogsett said, make sure you serve your community. That's exactly the reason why we came here today. I'd be hard-pressed not to believe that each one of us said that in some way or another during our interview process. So here's our opportunity to live out those words that we spoke. And finally, have fun. We keep being told that this is the greatest job in the world. So as long as you have a good attitude and good effort, I'm sure that having fun will be easy to have fun. See, I should have wrote something more. You were right. And our class motto was no strength without unity. Now, in the beginning, I think it was just a collaboration of what people thought were cool words to put together. I don't think anybody really understood that the fact that there were two classes essentially in one, that at some point that we would have to come together. And in doing so, we manifest that motto. So hopefully that we continue to live that out and we can become what this staff wanted us to become. And finally, just a blanket thank you to everybody. Thank you to the staff. Thank you to the class. I'm honored to be able to stand up here with Shante and to no longer be the class leader. I'm ready to void all my responsibilities and for the next 5 minutes or so be a recruit firefighter. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to invite Recruit Deem up and Chief Dryman. We would like to present our class plaque.
84 on three. 1, 2, 3.
This time I'd ask Chief Malone to come up to the podium and administer the swearing in, administer the oath of office. Class 84, on your feet.
Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name. Do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States. And the Constitution of the State of Indiana. And that I will discharge my duties regardless of the race, creed, color, religion, sex, or national origin of the persons I serve, and that I will faithfully and impartially discharge my duties as a firefighter of the City of Indianapolis. Under this appointment, according to law and the city ordinances, to the best of my ability, so help me God. Congratulations.
Okay, well now we're going to present the badges. As your recruit, we're going to do it in alphabetical order. As your family member is called, we ask your family to come to stage left, and you guys will be come up and you will pin. We have a mark in the middle where you guys will meet, and they will be presented with their badges. Gabriel Berry. Jacob Blackwell. Thank you. Jennifer Blake. Timothy Bowden. Logan Bowman. Joseph Branson. Andrew Brummett. Jerome Campbell. Keith Cherry. John Connor. Ryan Condiff. Mitchell Deem. Tyler Dix. Alan English. Christopher Estridge. Craig Fout. Eric Freeman. Jake Gildersleeve. Clinton Hacker. Randall Hall Jr. Victor Hamilton. Parker Hansen. Charver Harper. Thank you. Sydney Hayes. Shanti Holland. Keith Jennings. Colin Philip Johnson. Colin Leahy. Joshua Lennon. Daniel Loyal. Aaron Mann. Michael McDermott. Jeffrey McDowell, Jr. Evan McDonald. Daniel McManus. Mason McQuigg. Mark Moran. Kara Newton. Nico Powerbottom. Lindsay Raker. Ryan Reed. Jonathan Riddle. Megan Ridley. Brandon Ritter. Ronald Sanders. John Samoltz. Russell Snyder. Corey Schott. John Siegel. Kim Seidensucker. Levi Seymour. Andrew Seiler. Brandon Sullivan. Sundenheimer. Douglas Swayze. Thomas. Travis Tornquist. DeAndre Townsend. Thank you. Will Turner Jr. Nathaniel Waldrop. Alante Washington. Ron Wills. Last but not least, John Wilson. Okay, next we'll have awards. The first award is going to be our PT Physical Fitness Award. This award is sponsored by Public Safety Medical. This award recognizes the recruit who has exhibited the most positive attitude and enthusiasm toward working out and physical fitness in general, as well as exhibiting excellent physical fitness. This recipient is based on attitude, effort, performance, and a daily addition to the periodical testing that they do. Would Christopher Estridge come forward? Christopher Estridge has displayed a high level effort, not only for himself, but toward his peers.
exceptional performance and encouragement and leadership shown during PT. Please join me in congratulating recruit Christopher Estridge, Class of 84, Physical Fitness Award recipient. Next, we have the J.C. Smith Mental Attitude Award. This award is sponsored by Complete Office, and it will be presented by Division Chief Eric Dryman. This award recognizes the recruit with the exemplary attitude, bearing, demeanor, and it showed during the recruit class. This recipient is select based on the Recruit Academy recommendation. Would Karen Newton come forward, please? Recruit Newton has far exceeded the requirements for consideration for this award. Her attitude, bearing, demeanor were consistent and above board. Recruit Newton continually displayed the traits of positive mental attitude throughout the recruit class. Please join me in congratulating recruit Karen Newton, 84, J.C. Smith Mental Attitude Award. The Paul K. Jolliffe Emergency Medical Technician Award. This award is sponsored by the Professional Firefighters Union, 416, and is presented by Captain Mike Scott, Union President. This award recognizes the recruit with EMT, the best EMT medical technician for the best outstanding classroom, practical skills performance, and promoting better patient care and services. This recipient was selected by the EMT staff based on his performance. Would Andrew Seiler please come forward? Recruit Seiler has displayed qualities by assisting the EMS staff, directing and coordinating EMS skills, and showed exceptional willingness to help others. Please join me in congratulating Recruit Seiler, Class 84, EMT Award. The Clyde Long Outstanding Recruit Firefighter Award. This award is sponsored by the Police and Fire Insurance and will be presented by Captain Eric Hoffmeister. It recognizes the fire recruit for exceptional overall performance during the fire portion of the Recruit Academy. This recipient is selected based upon the academic performance, contributions, and instructor's recommendation. Would Brandon Sullivan please come forward? Brandon has earned the respect of the instructor staff as well as his peers for his professionalism, and his actions. Please join me in congratulating Brandon Sullivan as the outstanding recruit firefighter for the class of 84. The Gary Henry Peer Respect Award. This award is presented by our good friends at Ryan Fire Protection, presented by Mr. Mark Riffey. This award recognizes the recruit for exceptional performance based on his peers' opinion. The recipient was selected based on a tally of votes taken by his recruit class. Would Jacob Blackwell please come forward? The recognition is based on the popularity and compliments based on the respect and care that he's earned from his recruits. Recruit Blackwell Pierce has this award was bestowed on him by his peers. Please join me in congratulating recruit Jacob Blackwell as IFD Recruit 84 Gary Henry Award winner. The next award is the David Short Spotlight Award. David Short was a recruit who was tragically killed in a car accident. This award is sponsored by Public Safety, the Indy Public Safety Foundation. This award is presented by Dane Nutty, and Chris Worsler. This award is dedicated in recognition to a recruit who is a first-time firefighter with no previous experience. Would recruit Shante Holland please come forward? Recruit Holland has displayed high moral character, exceptional performance on the pad, and he's also excelled in the phase of helping other recruits and earned their respects. Would you please join me in congratulating Recruit Holland as the first ever David Sharp Spotlight Award winner. The Indianapolis Firefighter Valedictorian Award. This is sponsored by the Indianapolis Black Firefighters and presented by Captain Corey Floyd. This award recognizes the recruit with the exceptional performance in the entire recruit academy, both fire and EMS, and his accumulated scores in the classroom as well as practical skills on the pad. The recipient is based upon the combination of his grade point average, practical skills, performance, as well as his PT grade. Would Daniel McManus please come forward? Obviously, Recruit McManus has excelled as a recruit. By virtual combination of his grade point average, both in fire, EMS, and academics, as well as performance on the pad, fire, EMS, and PT, join me in congratulating Daniel McManus as the valedictorian of Recruit Class 84.
Thank you.
this time I'd call Chaplain Gatliff back up to give us the benediction.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we have been blessed this evening. We thank you for supplying us with these wonderful recruits, now probationary firefighters. We thank you for this leadership team who has trained them in wonderful ways. And my prayer and our prayer for them is that they not only do good at what they do, but they are well as they do it. Thank you for these family members and loved ones that have come out tonight to celebrate, and I pray for their continued support and encouragement and strength that will be behind each one of these firefighters as they pursue excellence each and every shift. So, Father, we again thank you for those who are out serving right now, and we pray for those who begin this week that you will truly bring glory and honor to yourself as you protect the citizens of Indianapolis. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you. That concludes the graduation ceremony for this evening. We have refreshments out in the entryway. You're all welcome to partake of. If anyone would like to get a photo up here with the class plaque or anything, you're also welcome to do that as well. Thank you for coming and have a good evening.